Amigo. Okay, so this is Dell PowerEdge RD740. We are going to be unboxing this Dell EMC PowerEdge R740 dual processor, and this cost about 4,149 euro, excluding shipping and VAT. So should cost about should cost about 2.4 million in Naira. So I'm going to be opening this. There are multiple compartments in there for the rings, the front bezel, and the chassis. Okay, so each compartment houses the railings, as you can see, metallic railing for your rack. Comes with some manual. On these other compartments, we have the front bezel. Or the front chassis. Then, underneath this, you can see what we have here. It's well protected to absorb shock. Just in case during the shipping, there are some kind of impact on the cathode. So this is the server. There are a lot of inscriptions in the front here. The hard drive bay, you can scan to validate your service tag. And if I lift it up, you see the front panel here. Here is the service tag. It has a barcode. You can see the inscription: Dell EMC PowerEdge R740, including some other barcode there. So we have this flange which you can lift. It's on both sides. This helps you to pull the server out of the railing when it's in the rack. And beneath it is a screw you can use to lock it permanently. You can decide to lock it permanently, you can leave it free. This is the VGA port. We don't have USB 3.0 here. You might not be needing it that much because most of your files you'll be copying comes through the network. So we have USB 2.0, two of it here. Then we have the CD drive. And here are the hard drive slots. From here to here is the hard drive bay. We have 0 to 7. Comes by default with one hard drive, SAS 12 gig hard drive, that's the copying speed. And this hard drive is 1 terabyte. You can decide to have two terabytes per slot. But it is advisable that if you want to have more than 2 terabytes per slot for 8 slots, it is better you have a storage network or a storage area network and network storage. You can have network storage of about 2 terabytes up to 12 petabytes to work with this, depending on the hypervisor you'll be installing on it. Now, on the back, we have 2 power units, 4 LAN ports, another extra VGA port, and ILO port. So, that is all about the unboxing. We will move to the next session when we get to open the cover here and we see the interior part of the server. So now we want to remove the chassis here, and if you look closely, you'll find a screw. You can lock this by using a screwdriver so that nobody, not even just anybody, can just come and open this, because the moment you open this, the chassis is open. You can see that I can raise this right now, but if you lock it with the screw, it becomes permanently locked. Whoever wants to open it will have to look for a screwdriver or something, just a safety precaution. So here is what we have in here. We have about six powerful fans cooling the processor. Six powerful fan, and the direction of airflow is this way. You can see by the arrow here, the direction of airflow is this way. So right now I'm going to open this compartment to show you the two processors. Each processor is about 16 core, then another 16 core, that is 32 core processor. This is 16 core, this is 16 core. Now, the RAM, we have about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. I think it's about 24 slots, if I am correct. So we currently have about 128 gig RAM on this server. 128 gig RAM. So we want to install the CMOS battery. I'm just going to launch this. So this CMOS battery is what keeps your BIOS settings, even when you power down the server for days, weeks, your BIOS settings remain the same. BIOS settings such as boot setting and every other setting you're going to do on the server. This is what retains your configuration. So by default, this does not come with CMOS battery. So we had to go and get this. And while installing, you make sure this front terminal faces down. You apply just a little pressure. Once it's properly seated, you can press. And that's it. It's intact. So we have covered most of what we have around the back here, but in the front here, remember I showed you from the previous video that we have the hard drive bay, and that bay from the back, you see the SAS 12 gig connectors here. It may not be very clear, but this is what connects the hard drive to the controller, the RAID controller. If you trace the cable, you find the cable goes this way, all the way down here to this chip here. This card is the RAID controller. This is where you configure your RAID 1, RAID 2, RAID 5, so that you can have parity packets for redundancy and, you know, prevent data loss. Unlike your regular PC where you just have one hard drive and when it goes bad, that is the end. Servers don't do that. You have multiple hard drives, and when one goes bad, there's a backup of your files and configuration on another hard drive. So I'm going to leave this out. We have covered mostly what we have inside the server, the accessories that are needed here could increase more than what we have currently, because we require a GPU card depending on what you want to do with the server. We currently don't have a GPU card here. If you need a GPU card, you are going to have to contact Dell about it before your purchase, so that they can integrate it into your unit before it is shipped. So that is it for the interior of the Dell PowerEdge R740. In the next video, we are going to power this up and we are going to talk about the power unit. We are going to talk about the initial configuration, the ILO in the units.